The Lord is so good. Amen.
Amen.
And whatever you are going through, God is good. I said He is a God of the seasons. He is a God of the valleys and God of the mountains. David said, I look on the mountains. Where does my help come from? And he said, though I walk in the valley of the shadow of death. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Though I walk through the shadow of the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. For thou art with me.
Amen.
Amen. God is with you no matter what you're going through. That's why I'm teaching you how to overcome afflictions. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why I'm teaching you, how do you stand in the day of afflictions? And you need to know, where are these afflictions coming from? When you know where the afflictions are coming from, you are able to overcome. If it is God, remain in God. For as Job says, if though you slay me, I will still stand up. I will still worship you, sorry. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he remained steadfast. But if it is, you are the one who has caused these afflictions through an open door, then you'll need to do something about it. Because it's not the will of God for you to go through afflictions. So you've been looking at it. I said, how do I come out of afflictions? Especially if it is myself, it is me who have around them to come to my life. Glory to God.
Amen.
And we talked about hearing God. Hearing God. And we said, you can miss out because you hand God wrongly. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Or you not follow instructions of God. The Bible says, do not be quick to go in the presence of God. In other words, do not be quick to speak in the presence of God. Do not be rash. Take time in the presence of God. Do you know why? He says, so that you may not talk like a fool. Be a person who listens more. Meaning, sometimes we go to God when we are rushing. God gives us instructions, but we don't wait for all the instructions. When we begin to do certain things, then we find ourselves, things are not working. And you say, why God? Because you are rushing. You did not wait enough to hear the full instructions. In the book of Judges 20, Judges, Waamuzi 20, the Bible tells us there was war between the children of Israel and the Benjamin in Gibeah, because there was a problem there. They had killed one of a wife of a concubine of a Levite. So the children of Israel went to God. And they wanted to understand. Because they wanted God to be with them in this war. Remember, they were fighting against their own tribesmen. But the Bible says they were in a hurry. They went to God and said, who shall go first? God told them, Judah shall go first. God answered. And they went to that war, and they were beaten down by the children of Benjamin. They were killed. 26,000 men were killed. So the next day they came again to God. Was it the will of God for them to go? Yes. But they did not take time to listen. Have a listening ear. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Be quick to listen more than to talk. So they went back to God. And then they did not say, who shall go first? They asked God, should we go up now? They questioned whether it is the will of God. God told them, go up. Hallelujah. This time they waited on God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But they did not do something. They're not humble enough. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So they went. And the 18,000 were killed. Yet it was the will of God to give them victory. So the next day they came again crying to God. The Bible says they fasted and they stayed in the presence of God up to the evening. Then God finished the whole instructions. He's saying, go and I'll be with you and I will deliver you. And they went and had victory. God was with them. God gave them strategy. But before then, they suffered. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So God can be with you in something. But failure to listen and tell enough to hear the full instruction, you can end up suffering, but it's because you have not gotten the full instruction. Even something you spoke with God and you are suffering, go back to God. Tarry a little bit more. Fast and wait on God. The fasting breaks the flesh and makes you sensitive to the spirit. Your antenna in the spirit are enhanced and you are able to receive from God. Get me somebody. There are people who are suffering, they want to say it is not God. Yet God is in you in whatever you are intending to do. All you needed is to listen a bit more. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I know sometimes you go to prayer. And we speak, we pray. But you don't give time to God a chance for him to speak. And then you say, God has heard my prayers. Now I can go and do what I wanted to do. And you find it's not working. Not because God is not for it, but he needed to give you instructions. And when he was speaking, you did not hear. Because you are talking. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You are engaged. You are engaged. But your spirit could not hear God. Today I want to go to the fifth one. And it's refusal to forgive. Why people get afflicted and it's not God involved. Why people suffer. The fifth point is refusal to forgive and opening a door of bitterness, a door to the devil to afflict and cause pain. Are you getting me, somebody?
Yes.
I said, sometimes you are afflicted because you have opened a door to the devil. Whoever makes a hole on the hedge, he shall be beaten by a serpent. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I remember this time, there was a time I was preaching in Timboroa. And when I was there, hallelujah, I was told there's a girl. I was requested to go and pray for her. I told them, bring this girl to the service. I was holding conferences, evening revivals. So they said, the girl cannot come. I said, why? Because they say the girl seems to be possessed and even to be taken to hospital It takes 9 men. And sometimes she overpowers them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I said, okay, I'll come. It had rained so much. And so we went. And then he went. Hallelujah. I found her in the kitchen of her mama. And the eye she looked at us with, I'm telling you. So we stayed there to pray for her now. I said, let us pray for her. So she was called now to the table room. And as I was praying over her life, God told me, I was casting out those devils. God told me, this girl is bitter. So bitter. She has refused to forgive. So God told me, ask her to forgive. And she'll be free. Remember, this is a girl possessed. She had given birth to a baby. She was not eating. She was so thin that she could bring down 9 men. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So as I prayed for her, I stopped and I asked her, so and so. God is telling me you are bitter in the spirit. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so, I would like you to forgive. Who has wronged you? So I came to realize it's because the young man who had made her pregnant and ditched her away. Hallelujah. So she grew very bitter. And in the process, there was a connection with some witchcraft from the boy's place. So she was possessed with demons. And not one. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I led her to a prayer of forgiving the boy. And when she forgave the boy, I prayed for her. And I casted out those devils. And she was free. 3 months, I think 4 months later, I came back to the area to preach again. And somebody, I was with another man of God. And somebody stopped us on the road. A woman. And I said, how are you? She said, Pastor, I would like to say hi to you. I did not know this woman. She said, I know you cannot recognize me. No, it was down 6 months. It was 6 months. I told her, yeah, I don't know you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
She said, Pastor, the girl you prayed for, who was so thin and dying, possessed, I am the one. Oh my, God is a God of wonders. You not have recognized her. Because God had given her beauty again and restored her health. Why am I telling you? I'm saying bitterness and forgiveness brings in oppression. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we do not forgive, we close the door to God's forgiveness of our own sins. And we give a room to the accuser to oppress us. Are you there, somebody?
Yeah.
Forgiving somebody. The Bible tells us in Mark 11:25, when you start praying, forgive. If you have something against any, that your Father also which is in heaven may forgive you your trespasses. Many people don't like forgiving. But again, let me tell you, you cannot be healed without forgiving. Forgiveness is for your own sake. Not for the person you're forgiving. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible is telling us, when you stand to pray and you remember there's somebody whom you have not forgiven, forgive. That your Father also in heaven may forgive you. Because if you do not forgive, neither you, your Father which is in heaven, forgive your trespasses. Are you hearing that? That if you don't forgive, two things will happen. God will not hear your prayers. And God will not forgive you. And if God will not forgive you, the devil will be near to you more than before. He will be your friend. Because the devil does not forgive. Neither does he seek forgiveness. Are you getting me, somebody? So, unforgiveness opens doors for affliction. The Bible tells us of a parable that Jesus gave of two servants. One servant owed his master a lot of money, and he went and asked for forgiveness because his children could have been sold out. Hallelujah. And even the whole family. And the master forgave him. But then he was coming, this servant was coming back. Having been forgiven, he met another servant. Hallelujah. Who owed him? He has a few amount of money. And he said, "You must pay me." He forgot he has been forgiven. And now he is using force. And I say, you must pay my debt. When the other servant fell on his knees, this man servant said, throw him to the prison until he pays everything. He has been forgiven a lot, but he could not forgive. Matthew 18:32. This thing was told his master. And the Bible says, I'm saying it was told his master by the other servants. By other servants. Other servants told their master that somebody has not forgiven. Amen. Hallelujah. So his Lord, the Bible says, then his Lord, after that, he called him. And he called him and said, oh, thou wicked servant, I forgave thee all the debts because you asked me. Should you not have had compassion on your fellow servant, even as I had pity on thee? And his master was angry and he delivered him to tormentors. I want you to underline that he delivered him to tormentors. He delivered him to affliction. Are you getting me, somebody? Till he should pay all that was due unto him. And Matthew 18:35 says, so likewise shall my heavenly Father do also unto you, if from your hearts you forgive not everyone his brother their trespasses. You see what God is saying? That as that master did, and threw this servant to a place of torment, so shall our heavenly Father do to us when we fail to forgive. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Who takes people in prison? The devil. Are you getting me, somebody? So when we don't forgive, we are setting ourselves up as a candidate for affliction, as a candidate to be oppressed. And forgiveness, here he says, if you don't forgive from your heart. Many people forgive from their head, not from their mind, not from their heart. I forgive you, but I'll never forget. Or I'll not tell them, I'll never forget. I'll forgive, but I'll always remember. Whenever we meet with you, I'll remember what you did to me. Though I forgave you. Forgiving from the head. The head you'll never forget. But the Bible says, if you not forgive from the heart, forgiveness is a function of the heart, not of the head. It's not of the mind. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. He says, if you do not forgive, Glory to God.
Amen.
God will not forgive you. He'll leave you. And demons will have a feast. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Amen.
So bitterness comes about when you fail in the grace of God. Are you getting me, somebody?
Amen.
I will tell you why. When we fail to forgive, you fail in the grace of God. And forgiveness is an act of despising the grace of God. You despise the finished work of Christ on Calvary. Hallelujah. Why? Because all of us have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. And so all of us depend on the grace of God for forgiveness of our sins. So if I depend on grace, God forgive me, I want Him to forgive me, but I don't want to forgive somebody else. I'm despising what Christ has done. Because all of us before God, we are equal. And sinners who need forgiveness. Are you together, somebody? We are all sinners who need forgiveness. So when we don't forgive, we are trying to ask God something, but we are so mean, we cannot give what we want. What we require from God, you cannot give to somebody else. Let me put it this way. What you cannot give, you cannot receive.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What you cannot give, you cannot receive.
Amen.
And that's a principle. He says, give and you shall receive. Press down, shaken together, running over. When you have mercy on others, God will have mercy on you. He will cause others to have mercy on you. When you are merciless, you also receive the same portion, the same way. Do you know why? Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm not trying to scare you. We reap from what we plant. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, because whatever you give is a seed that grows and gives you back of its own kind in increased portions. I want you to get this very clearly. Whatever you give, when you forgive, is a seed you give. When you have somebody, have mercy on somebody, is a seed you give. So whatever you give is a seed. I wish you could write that. Because it's something that will take you far. Whatever you give is a seed that grows and gives you back of its own kind in an increased portion. Are you getting somebody? When you give love, it's a seed you planted. You receive it. You receive love in an increased, having multiplied portions. When you give forgiveness, when you forgive other people, you receive back. Because even you trespass against other people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And you receive the same. Whoever you have mercy, you receive mercy. Are you getting me, somebody? So if you forgive, you receive forgiveness. So Paul is warning us about bitterness. When you keep on unforgiveness, it brings in bitterness. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are there some people you look at and you see when you meet them, you feel bad, you feel like you don't want to talk to them? Because they wronged you? That tells me Though you said you forgave them, it was by your minds. When God forgives you, He forgets. The Bible says He throws it to the sea, ocean of forgetfulness. Hallelujah. He does not look at you as a sinner anymore. When you forgive and not look at that person as if he trespassed against you. Paul warns about bitterness. Hebrews 12:15. Hallelujah. As we open, there are some people I've prayed for. And they come to me, and God told me they have unforgiveness. And I told them, forgive that God may heal you. Forgive that these demons be casted out. I remember someone told me, I'll never forgive. And I want to say, if you say that, even God will say, I'm out of that transaction. I could not pray for them, because I would just waste my time. I just canceled them and gave them a space to go and think whether they can forgive. Because the Bible is saying, if you don't forgive, even your Heavenly Father will not forgive you. And He will not hear your prayers. So there are some people who have been praying, because they are going through afflictions. Maybe it can be through family. You are praying for your husband, but you are bitter against him. You will not get a solution. You are praying for your bosses, but you are bitter against them. And you say, I cannot forgive them. God will not intervene. When you forgive, you are letting go. And you are allowing God to take it over. The Bible says, pray for those who despisely use you. Those who hate you. Your enemies, do them well. If you find them hungry, feed them. And it's like praising your cause on their head. And God, who is a God of vengeance, will go ahead for you. He will revenge for you. Don't afford to fight for yourself. What you plant, remember what I said, they will grow, increase, and they will come to you multiplied portions. Hallelujah. So in Hebrews 12:15, Paul is telling us that looking diligently lest any man fail of the grace of God. I want you, look, you don't fail in the grace of God. Our salvation is of grace. Whatever we get is of grace. We don't deserve it. If you fail of the grace of God, you can go to hell. Are you getting me, somebody? You can live a Christian life. But if you fail on the grace, you'll be afflicted. You will suffer and be thrown to hell. That's what Him God saying. You shall be thrown to tormentors now and in eternity. Because if you are thrown to the prison until you pay, how will you be able to pay your debt when you are in prison? I owe you money, I'm thrown to prison. I'll be tormented until the day I will pay. When did I pay? It means it's eternal torment. So the Bible is saying, look, you don't fail of the grace of God. Lest any root of bitterness springing up trouble you. And therefore many be defiled. So when unforgiveness grows to bitterness, it brings defilement. And anything defiled, God is not there. But But the devil is the chief of all defilements. I say, if you carry a lot of meat in your pocket, fries will never stop following you. However much you go and buy a spray, you will spray. For a moment, the fries will not be there. But for a certain, after 5 minutes, they will come back. Because you have not dealt with the cause of those fries. Bitterness, that's what it does. Unforgiveness is carrying a rotten meat in your pocket. Demons will always follow you. Whether you fast and pray, whether we put anointing oil on you and pray with a whole drum, of it, demons, they will come. Is when you remove the rotten meat from your pocket. Remove bitterness from your heart. And then you can pray for you. Meaning we shall pray that you be wiped where the rotten meat was. Now be washed by the blood. And the fries, the demons, they will stop following you. Okay, hallelujah.
Amen.
Defilement, bitterness brings demonic possession. And it brings oppression. And it brings sicknesses. Such as high blood pressure, migraine. There are oppressions of sicknesses related to unforgiveness and bitterness. You can come back to God. If you are being afflicted and you are bitter, in whatever situation, forgive from your heart. And our Father in heaven will forgive you. And afflictions will come to an end. Because when you pray, God will hear you. I shall deliver you from all your afflictions. God bless you and keep you. Amen.